I know, like, the amount of shit that other people are on, and comparatively, it's just like, man, y'all are crazy.
It's like drinking a monster.
Like, me, it's like so PG compared to them. It's like hardcore fucking porn. Welcome back, YouTube. Today, we got a little push day, Wednesday, day before our check-in. So, pushing it hard today, warming up with some dumbbell work just to kind of get those stabilizing muscles woken up so we can hopefully recruit a little bit more force on the flies and other incline presses and just general chest work today. Chest is gonna be the main emphasis really for all of our push days with a little bit of shoulder accessory work and of course, always hitting some arms. So yeah, just trying to get some smooth tempo here, slight pause at the bottom, and then just keep tension in the chest as much as possible. So it'll kind of be all the way down and then like 90-95% all the way up. We're hitting a lot of our compound incline pressing work first. Started off with dumbbells, got a lot of stability work in, kind of pre-fatigued the chest a little bit, got it really active, feeling really good. Good stretch, good activation. So now we're going incline, less stability, more force production, but obviously we're a little pre-fatigued more than we would be had we not done the dumbbells. So just trying to kind of find a good balance with weight without sacrificing too much stimulus. So if I have to go lighter and I feel more activation in my chest, that's way better than me being able to hit, you know, a really, really heavy set with not a whole lot of stimulus. Okay, so we'll drop the weight down, hit two back down sets with some lighter weight, and just get a lot of reps in, somewhere in like 15 to 20 rep range even. Whew. That was a good stretch. I kind of feel a lot more upper pec, clavicular pec, when I'm kind of like directing the bar almost to my throat. Much lighter weight, but much better stimulus. Yeah, we are in the humbling stages of prep. 37 days to go. Strength is a little low today. Fatigue probably a little high. Usually we get a rest day tomorrow and then we feel pretty good by Saturday or Sunday to press again. So, but today going after, you know, 4 or 5 days in a row of training, the systemic fatigue definitely accumulates. So all I'm really thinking about there is, as my hands are coming to me, I'm trying to bring my chest to my hands to essentially try and think about opening up my chest as much as possible, lengthening my pecs as much as possible, and pulling my scapula back as much as possible. It just feels like a little bit more of an intentional stretch. Okay. Move on to some cable flies and then we get some dips and then it's all shoulders and triceps from there. Ah. hitting some body weight dips, just three sets to failure, get a good stretch in the pec. Just a good little finisher before we move on to shoulders and triceps. This shit is heavy right now. I used to do 100 dips every day. And right now, doing more than 8 seems like a miracle. Other movements are way harder. So it'd be like, you don't want to be super fatigued and accumulate so much fatigue and then like go into a leg day. You can handle a little bit more stress on a push day. So like, it's not bad, but I would like to feel fresh on a push day for a change. After my show, you need to cancel your lunch plans. We're gonna go to Perry's and get some pork chops. I don't know, I'll just be whatever I crave. Probably just like a burger or something. Oh, probably we'll do another show in like July or August. Try to get, yeah, so I'll try to get it up to like 250, 260. I'm just doing a little rest pause myo rep set here. So resting the nervous system and then just going right back into it. Just get those effective reps. So kind of myo rep concept is we're gonna do one set to near failure, rest just enough for the nervous system to recover, but not necessarily the muscle, and then repeat sets just like that. So we'll do one more set here, and that way the muscle is always kind of just doing the subsequent sets are all those effective reps, right? So like if you do a set of 10, it's really like the last 3 reps that are really hard. So it's those 3 reps that are kind of making the stimulus, making the change. And so by cutting down those rests, doing more like rest pause, myo rep style, you're able to kind of get more effective reps without all the kind of fluff volume in between. All one side, one set, just kind of normal. And then that second set is just all those myo rep sets. So now we'll repeat on the right side. Oh, it's, yeah, it's just cream, it's cream of rice. It's the, it's the easiest thing for you to digest. No, I mean, the brownie batter is my favorite. Crackberry is really good. The lemon pound cake's really good. Yeah, but the client that I have that works with her is, he's got a bunch of digestive stuff and I have him on the Flavor Gang stuff too.
Have you seen those carnivore snacks that are just like dehydrated, like straight meat? So, did you see how expensive that shit was? One bag of 5 ounces of meat is $140.
Okay, one normal set there, and then we'll go myo rep set. I made a little like protein frosting, so you just get the protein and just. Oh yeah, it's so easy. And that's why I have it. It's good, like good post workout, good pre workout. One more set here. Five, four, three, two, one. Go machine lateral raise. I feel like people don't do blood work just because they're so scared of like finding something. So they're like, they'd rather be just ignorant to it.
No, I always feel like getting excited.
Yeah, I do too. Because I love it just interpreting the data and then being like, cool, what can I optimize? What can I change?
I play so much video games, I want my stats.
Yeah. I want my sabermetrics. Except if you're scared of needles. Yeah, you just gotta do more frequent doses, just use the insulin needle. It's cake. I'll do it for you.
Is it click or is it like you have to feed that bitch?
The insulin needles, they draw slower, obviously, because they're thinner. Right, I mean, you're trying to like suck us. Real thick smoothie through a coffee stir. As opposed to a boba straw. I know like the amount of shit that other people are on and comparatively it's just like, man, y'all are crazy.
It's like drinking a monster.
Like me, it's like so PG compared to them. It's like hardcore fucking porn. Also, just when you get to, you're coming off of like a sickness.
Those 3 weeks are just sedentary.
Yeah. Me, like being this late in like my prep, it's just you don't really have energy to do anything.
What are you sitting at, like 50 right now, 60?
Resting heart rate's like 48. It's low.
You said that my chest is a little bit deeper, I might never wake up.
Just one myo rep set here. So rest about 10, 15 seconds. And so you can get another like 5 reps or so. close. We're just finishing off here with some crossbody tricep extensions, and then we'll get some JM presses, and then we'll be out of here. So just gonna try and keep the stimulus high, not worry too much about the weight, because we are feeling pretty fatigued. We've been digging since last Thursday, so it's a pretty long time. Ooh. Shake that off a little bit. Right back into it. Good way when you're in prep, you know, you don't always get super good pumps. So do a little Maya rep action and get the pump back. Get creative. JM press time. Okay, so that is a wrap for today. Solid push day. Honestly, just a lot of higher rep, lighter weight stuff, but just feeling good stimulus, good stretch, just kind of chasing the stimulus. So load was probably a little bit lighter than we did last week, pretty consistently overall, but not really worried about load right now, just worried about contracting the muscle, lengthening the muscle, getting into a good stretch. So now we're getting a little post-workout. We've got just some straight up oatmeal. And I don't know, just was craving oatmeal today as opposed to the cream of rice post-workout. So I had cream of rice this morning, a little oatmeal post-workout. And then we've got our protein Ninja Creamy, little sugar-free maple syrup for a little bit of flavor, a little bit of sea salt. So shout out Vermont. Apparently that's like a big thing there, is a creamy before the Ninja Creamy was even invented. So we're gonna eat this. We gotta check in tomorrow with Nick, see where we're at weight-wise, body composition-wise, just overall look, feel, things like that. And then we'll just keep plugging along. Leg day on Friday, pull day on Saturday, push day again on Sunday, and just keep going until we get to showtime. 37 days, yeah. It'll be here before you know it. So thanks for liking, watching, following, subscribing, loving, hating, all that stuff. And we will see you on the next one. Bo Alexander, Adapt Fitness, Battle of Texas. We are coming to win. Bye. I love oatmeal.